book of Joshua, chapter number 1, verse number 1 to verse number 9.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over to Jerusalem, you and all these people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I said to Moses. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and to the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you. Be strong and of good courage. For these people you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to the law which Moses my servant commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left, that you may prosper wherever you go. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Father, we love you. We thank you because of the power in your word. We pray as we partake of this word, you are going to lift us up into the new dispensation in Jesus' name. We love you. We exalt you. Holy Spirit, this is your meeting. Have your way. In Jesus' name we pray.
Topic tonight, a new dispensation. A new dispensation. A new dispensation.
Let me begin by saying, you will never understand growth until you know what you are growing from and what you are growing into. You will never understand growth until you understand what you are growing from and what you're growing into. Because life is life. Until you have lived life long enough to understand that kuna mahali nafika inakupiga chenga, na kuna mahali nafika you think you're stagnating. At some point you may think you're not making it, and at some point you may deceive yourself and think you are really making it. But the truth is, until you understand where you are coming from and where you are going to, is when you will understand what growth is all about. Growth is not about increase. Growth is not about more. But growth is about understanding what God has called you to do and whether you are accomplishing it or not. In the Bible, there are people God called and they failed in their mission. Not because they were not anointed enough, but because they were not obedient enough. Tonight, I want us to understand that God has brought us into a new dispensation. A new dispensation means he has brought us into a new place, a new level, whereby there are new things he wants us to capture, new things he wants us to do, but he does not want us to do them with an old mentality, but he wants us to do them with an understanding, to understand that there are people who were there before us. They did not fail because we are picking up from them and we are going on with what God has anointed us to do. So the moment you understand there are people who are before us and we are picking up from them, it means we are not better than them, but we are accomplishing what they began. And some time to come, some years to come, there are people who are going to come after us and they are going to do better than us. Meaning, we are not worse, neither are we the best, but we have to understand if there are people coming after us and they are going to be better than us, then all we have to do is do our best. Somebody say amen. All we have to do is do our best. Because everybody thinks growth is about having more money than you have today. Growth is about having a bigger ministry than you're having today. There are people who have many things and they were rich. People like Solomon in the Bible. And they grew in wealth. But when it came to ministry, they failed. When it came to representing God, they failed. When it came to them being a priest, they failed. Why? Because growth is not material. Growth is when you accomplish what God has assigned you to do. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. So growth is determined by the willingness for you to obey. How willing are you for you to obey what God commands you to do? I want you to understand, God will never lift anyone. God will never raise anyone without him giving you a condition that if you meet that condition, you go through. If you do not meet that condition, you fail in life. Why? In the beginning, when he put Adam and Eve in the garden, he put a tree in the middle of the garden. And that tree had no sin. That tree had nothing evil. It only had a decree from God. If you do not touch this tree, you will not die. But if you touch this tree and eat from this tree, you will surely die. So, I want you to understand that the fruit on that tree, it was not poisonous. What was there, it was a condition that God sets. Now, in our normal lives, we are unable to move with life. We are unable to accomplish things in life. We are unable to hit our ultimate because we break the condition God has put in our lives. In every area of our lives, there is a condition. You will never get to a new level in your life and live the same way you were living before. God will always put something yenye mnaitaga kukaziwa. He will always put something that you'll call a thorn in the flesh. Because sazile unambia mtoto, do not play around with fire. They begin wondering, why are you stopping them from playing with something that looks so beautiful? Because when you look at fire, it looks so beautiful. It looks more beautiful than water. But the truth is, mpaka sazile mtoto nachomeka, saizo na nagundua, as much as you are beautiful, sikupendi, I will never touch you again. And in our lives today, there are things God has set in our lives. There are called conditions. And these conditions, when we meet them, we make it. When we fail in them, we fail in life. Now, Joshua is a man who has been an assistant to Moses for quite some time. And the Bible says that when Moses died, God came to Joshua and told him, my servant Moses is dead. Understand, Joshua did not know whether Moses was dead. Until today, the theologians, the historians, they do not know and they have never located the grave of this man called Moses. But we have a confirmation, he is not alive. He is already dead. Why? Because now God reports to the next of kin what happened to the servant that was there before. And God comes to Joshua and tells him, Joshua, my servant Moses is dead. Now, rise up because I want to give you an assignment. Then when God begins speaking to Joshua, he begins speaking to Joshua from a reference of what he had told Moses. He did not give Joshua a completely new rule. No, he began by telling Joshua, I will be with you as I was with my servant Moses. In other words, wherever you step, I have given you, no problem. This promise had already been given to Moses before. But now, Joshua is moving into a dispensation whereby Moses did not fail. Moses finished his work. God did not anoint Joshua God did not raise Joshua because Moses failed. He raised Joshua because Moses finished the course. You want to be raised up? I want you to understand. You are not going to a place, and you are not coming to a place whereby you are presenting people and or representing other people because they failed. No, you are coming to a dispensation whereby God is bringing you to a place. Other people worked for you to get where you are. You have to congratulate them. You have to refer to that anointing and say, Father, I thank you for my mother. I thank you for my father. I thank you for my pastor. I thank you for my bishop. I thank you for my boss. Because where I am today, there is something they labored for. And that is why I am succeeding them today. Because success has a reference. I repeat, success has a reference. Now God comes and begins speaking to Joshua, but from a reference of Moses. Most people say that Moses failed, but let me bring it to your attention. Moses did not fail, because the primary agenda at the burning bush that God told him was, I want you to go and deliver my people from the captivity of the Egyptians. That was the primary agenda. And Moses did more than delivering them. So until now, I want you to understand, there are people in your life that you have seen and you think and say, you can do better than that. You are better than what you are. You are better than what you have done. But tonight I want you to understand, let everybody run their race, because even you and me, there are people who will come after us and show us how to do it better. What we are supposed to do is just do our very best. If it is praying, pray at your very best. If it is fasting, fast at your very best. If it is being a wife or a husband, be a wife or a husband at your very best. If it is being a mother or a father, be what you can be at your very best. Because growth has nothing to do with comparison. Growth has everything to do with completion. Somebody say amen. So you will never be contented in life until you understand you are not doing anything for anyone to see. You are doing things to make them complete. The problem of comparison is, you may compare yourself to me, and when you think you've done better than me, I failed. That is why you think you did better. And you gauged yourself on my failure and thought you are doing fine. Special announcement. Growth is never about comparison, never about competition, but everything about completion. What God has set before you, he needs you to finish it. Talk about Moses. He finished what God told him to do. At the burning bush, I want you to go and deliver my people from the hand of Pharaoh. And he goes like, when I go, what do I tell the children of Israel? Not Pharaoh. What do I tell the children of Israel? Because they will ask me, who sent you? Go and tell them, I am that I am. And go and tell them, I am has sent me to deliver you. So the primary agenda Moses was given was to deliver, to get them out. Never let life lie to you by what you have accomplished better than others. Others had a bigger task and a harder job to do. And maybe what you've been given is to take them into the promised land. My friend, do the best you can with what God has given you. If you are a waiter, be the best waiter you can ever be in life. If you are a singer, be the best singer you can ever be in life. If you are a preacher, be the best preacher you can ever be in life, knowing you will never please everyone. Somebody say amen. Because being the best has nothing with making everybody happy. It has everything to do with what you do to the ultimate. Now, Joshua comes to a point and he listens from God before he moves into action. He listens from God. Yesterday I was teaching our Bible study class and I told them, every time you want to begin anything, take some time with God before you begin that thing in your life. Because there are demons you fight with before you begin, and you set a foundation of winning the fight by listening and acquiring from God. Blanda, yenye si ufanya ndio hii. We get into it. When it becomes tough, that is when we begin praying and fasting. And now it becomes hard for you to hear the voice of God. Why? Because maybe unaomba na Mungu anasema no. What happens? What happens? Sazile, you want to begin something. Alafu sazile umejianda, unataka kuianzisha mahali fulani. Then ukianzisha inakata. Then ukienda kuomba, ndio Mungu anakuambia haikufaa kuwa hapo. What happens? You begin being frustrated and being in pain. Because we think that every time we fast and pray, God will say yes. That is what we think. But the truth is, God will say no if it is a no. Unaona? Hiyo ndio injili mpendi kusikia, lakini hiyo ndio ukweli. David fasted 7 days without eating, without drinking. Mtoto asikufe. Hakafunga siku ya saba, mtoto akakufa. Baadaye akaambia vijana wake, leteni chakula. Wakamuuliza, "Sir, you fasted, prayed, did not even eat. You are crying. Mtoto ameenda. Alafu unaitisha chakula unakula. Kwani unafikiriaje?" Akasema, "Mungu ameamua vile ameamua na siwezi mquestion wacha nikule niendelee na maisha." The question is, you pray and pray, but do you listen to God when he responds? The heart is deceptive. So never pray with your heart. Never pray with your mind. Pray with your spirit. Na wakuwaza nini? Sio makofi natafuta. Sio makofi na wakuwaza nini ama ndio inaingia zaidi. Because I do not want you to pray amiss. Because most people pray a lot, but they pray amiss. And it doesn't matter how long and how much you pray. As long as you are praying amiss, you are doing nothing. But if you pray right, you will get the right answer. What happens in your life that you do not like? Listen to me carefully. What happens in your life that you do not like? You are not supposed to question God. You are supposed to understand it has happened, but I am still alive. God has still kept me alive. Father, I thank you because I know as long as you have kept me alive, there is something great you have for me. So I will not focus on what has happened around me. I will focus on what you want to do with my life. Somebody say amen. Because Joshua, God comes and tells Joshua, Joshua, do we? Because Moses alimwambia wacha niende kwa mlima nikakutana na Mungu. He never came back. Sasa Joshua amekaa na gojea na gojea. Then God comes. But Allah God amwambie, now Joshua, Moses has gone to heaven. And amwambia bad news. Moses is dead. And because Joshua is a man of God and is the assistant and he knows his position, he does not begin weeping. The Bible does not say he wept. The Bible does not say he cried. He listened to God. He listened to God. Death is a mystery no one has ever understood. Death is a mystery no one will ever understand. The spiritual people even know it. I have lost close people in my life until it came to a point and I asked God, what does this have to do? Because enye ni uchungu. Until ilifika point
Mnasema ni joke, lakini it works for me. Nikisikia mtu ameenda na namjua, na assume ameenda Thailand. Ama UK. And we will meet one day. Nikienda huko, ama akikuja na sana sana ni mimi nitaenda. So, hakuna haja kulia, knowing that one day, one time, pia wewe, utakuwa tumekamata hiyo njia. Swali ni, utakuwa umemaliza kazi yako. Ongea kuhusu kitu kaya kwa church saa hii. Wateni niwaambie ukweli, rapture inakuja. Na niwazidishie ukweli, Yesu anarudi. Niangalieni tu hivyo, mtanikumbuka siku moja. Na pastor alituambia kitu kama hiyo, by the way. Ndiyo hii, Because the truth is, if you are walking with God, if you understand who God is, you will never be threatened by anything in this life. Joshua naambiwa, excuse me, Moses is dead, okay? What next? Alafu najua kuna kitu poa kama God kukuambia kuhusu kifo ya mtu mwingine, na ni God anakuambia. Because anakuambia na upako fulani, yenye hata uhitaji understanding. Understanding inakuja na wazi zenyewe. Moses is dead. Hale ushondere, bukar, bashadre, efeda. What next? Now I want you to rise and take my people and cross the Jordan River. Because this is not where you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be on the other side. Now Joshua begins understanding. I am not better than Moses. Because God has begun by referring to my former boss. He has begun by referring to my former, the one who set the legend, the one who set the pace. Now God is speaking to me not to undo what he did, but to finish what he started through him. Then Joshua is being given instructions by God. And now you are moving into a new dispensation. And it is now time for you to listen to the instructions of where you are. Where you are. Where you are. You will never succeed in a new place, in a new area, doing something new with what you are doing in your former place. You will never succeed. You need something new, a new strategy and new everything for where you are and where God is taking you. So Joshua is given an instruction and told, now, I want this word to never depart from your lips. Never. Never depart from your lips. I want to see victory. Then you have to speak victory. I want to become rich. Then you must speak like a rich person. I want to make it in life, then you must speak like a champion. Because this word, as long as it is in your mouth, it will give you victory. Now Joshua is being told by God, I want you to meditate upon the word day and night, and do not let it depart from your lips. We have so much to say, we have so much to argue, we have so much to debate about. But by the end of the day, do not let the word of God depart from your lips. Never allow yourself to speak against what the word says about you. Because the truth is, I may say something about you, but what the word says about you is what stands by the end of the day. Now the instructions that Joshua is now receiving, he is receiving instructions that Moses did not have at this particular point. Alafa naambiwa, now be strong and courageous. Strong and courageous. Meaning, when you are strong, you can fight. And when you are courageous, you will not fall in the fight. When you are strong, you will stand in the fight and fight. But courage comes whenever you're supposed to go down, you remember, my portion is being up, and you continue fighting. Now the instructions that he receives, and then he is told, as long as you will meditate upon the word of God day and night, and you will never allow it to depart from your mouth,
you will be prosperous.
Prosperity is not a result of how hard you work. Prosperity is a result of how the word works in your life.
Kuna mkikuyu anaweza interpret hiyo? Ama mjaka? Mluya? Wacha niseme in tongues.
Prosperity is not a result of you working hard. Prosperity is a result of the word of God working in your life. Now, the reason nakupatia hizi teachings, it is for you to understand we should get rid of getting excited in church and going home and living the same our lives the same way. Let reality sink in and you understand this year it will take the word of God for you to prosper. It will take the word for you to get to your next level. What you have been wishing, praying, and guessing for, all you need to do is to depend upon the word of God. You've depended upon your mind for some time. You've depended upon the people around you for some time. You've depended upon your job. You've depended upon your fiance or your fiancé. But today, I want you to depend upon the word of God. There are things people will tell you, and you will depend on what they say. For example, if a man engages a woman, the woman depends on when the man will decide to marry her. Ladies, let me give you a secret. Never depend on that man. Pindukia Mungu na mwambie baba, ile maturity tulimchapa nayo ndio akaniengage, sasa mchape na ingine kesho ya kunioa haraka in Jesus' name. Simple. Niki, sasa wewe unakaa hapa ti baba kwa jina la Yesu Kristo. Ninamuona, namuona, namuombea. Mpatie amani, anapewa na huyu jamaa anahitaji amani, anahitaji maombi makali. Na kupatia ufunuo because your boss will tell you, I am looking into your issue na akona issues zingine. If you want your issue to come to the limelight na ikuje ikwe kwa uso yake hivi na akose amani mpaka attend kwako, you need the word of God. Somebody say amen. Hizi vitu nakufunza ndio deep, hizo ndio zitakutoa mahali umekuwa. Sio next year saa kama hii, bado unaomba maombi ya saa hii. No, unafika level ingine. Because what you need is to capture the word and make it active in your life. Kwani Bible ina describe word aje? How does the Bible describe the word? The word of God is sharper than any double-edged sword. Hakuna mahali haiwezi kapenetrate. Inaweza kapenetrate kwa rais, inaweza penetrate kwa boss wako, inaweza penetrate kwa husband yako, inaweza penetrate kwa mama yako, kwa baba yako. All you need to do is declare that word and let that word penetrate on your behalf. Iko watu wagumu bana. There are people who are hard. Even when God was sending Moses, he told Moses, but Pharaoh will be stubborn. But I will give you victory by the end of it all. Na Moses hakuenda, akanyamazia Farao. Admeta alikuwa na stama, ilibidi aongee. Ongea wewe acha nini, ongea. Ongea na huyu jamaa. Anaongea na ongea na ongea. Plagues zinakuja, zinafanya until saa zile Farao aliona yenyewe this is too much. Plague ya mwisho ndio ujue word ndio ilifanya kazi. Plague ya mwisho haikufanywa, ilisemwa. Let God show you that he is God. Every firstborn in the whole of Egypt, firstborn of people and firstborn of cattle will die. That is word. Na akaenda. So sarakasi imeisha kuangusha kijiti. Inakuwa nyoka, inameza nyoka zingine. Hii itishi Farao because pia anaweza angusha. Yanaona nifuluki, zako yako ilimeza zake. Yanaona nifuluki. Lakini sasa ile word inaingia, my friend, vitu zinabadilika. Things change. Things change by the word. Hapana argue na watu, wacha watu waongee. Wewe nyamaza. Niliwaambia if you want to win an argument, bring in the word of God. Na ukiona mtu muna argue na bado anakataa neno la Mungu, toka mbio. Huyo sio mtu huyo. Anaweza kuwa ametumwa. Lakini argument zote ukitaka kushinda and not in a manipulative way. In a realistic way, apply the word of God and see how it works for you. So tonight, God has sent me for a simple agenda. It is for you to understand That after you have applied the word of God, because the Bible says, I have exalted my word above everything else. Number two, my word will never ever pass away. Mpaka Bible nasema, heaven and earth will pass away. Sasa jui kama heaven itaisha siku moja. But anasema, my word will never pass away. So why are we depending on temporary things to solve permanent solutions, permanent things, instead of depending on a permanent thing to solve our problems permanently? Because only the word is permanent in the entirety of our lives, the word. And in this new dispensation, yenye Mungu anaachilia, I want you to understand. There are some people listening to me right now, and I want you to make you understand what dispensation is. God is bringing you to a position where there were people before you were. I repeat, there are people who were where you are before. Some of you are being introduced to something new altogether. The secret is you cannot live your old life in your new place. You cannot live your old life in your new place. You will sabotage your success. Yesu mwenyewe alisemaje, you cannot put new wine into old wineskin because the new wine will break the old wineskin. So some of you listening to me, your father or your mother were great in something and you're supposed to take over. And what you've done, umepiga raundi, ukapiga raundi, ukapiga raundi, ukapiga raundi, hakuna kitu nafanya kazi. Ni wewe unafaa kujua. It is your time to enter into your new dispensation because someone has to take over what your mama or your papa were doing. So kwa watoto wachungaji, jinawaona kadhaa hapa leo. Nawaambiaga kila wakati. Ni wewe uamue tu. Hata usipoamua, number one, hauwezi kufa. Na kuambia hata ukapata, hata ukaenda ucheze kalongolongo uko nje, ushikwe na HIV, ushikwe na everything yenye nashikaga watu, ukweli ni kwamba Mungu lazima kutumie. You are not going anywhere. Anza tu safari mape. The earlier unaanza, the earlier unafika. Sasa wewe unacheza tu game zako, unacheza game zako, unacheza game zako. Haya, endelea. Bottom line ni nini? Someone in your family made it in business. You've been employed all your life thinking you're succeeding just because the business ilikuwa ya kiosk na ilikuwa ushago. So unadhani uko juu because uko employed. Alikuanzishia. And I'm telling you that because God wants you to refer. Somebody say amen. You have to refer. You have to refer. Listen, there are things and places your father or your mother or your guardian failed. And I'm telling you the truth. If it were you, you would fail even more. I guarantee you would fail even more. Na mchezo uko nayo, na Facebook uko nayo, Instagram uko nayo, simu yako ni attach. How walitoboa bila simu? Bila call box kwanza, na bila do. Walitoboa. Wewe, Pizza Hut umeletewa, ukaletewa KFC, ukaletewa McDonald's. Yani, umeletewa kila kitu ndio hizi hapa, na bado utoboi. Alafu niambie, hatunakaa kuangalia nyuma ati. Hawa, mimi, mbona hakunipenda vile alifaa kunipenda? My friend, alikupenda vile angeweza because alikuwa anachuna majani ndio akuchunge. Sister, and that is the reason why the moment you are unable to refer back, you are unable to succeed where you are because you are unable to appreciate your mother who is someone's wife, your father's wife. Eh? And you want to become a wife and a mother. And you are unable to refer. You want to become a boss and you are unable to refer back to your father. Ukisema ya kwamba, yeye, hakufanya vizuri, alifaa kufanya A, alifaa kufanya B. My friend, mark my words tonight. The moment you refer back to where you have come from, it is not going to your past. It is getting information that will enable you to tackle where you are today. So tonight, it is not about being excited. It's about knowing the reality. Because once you have known what I have told you, the scripture now comes in. And no man will stand before you. no man will stand before you. Because there are people who have come into your life and they have stood in front of you and they sabotaged your success. They messed you up. Today you are not who you are supposed to be because someone came into your life and messed it up. But tonight, God is saying, for the rest of your life, not today, not tomorrow, but for the rest of your life, no man will stand before you. Meaning, they have been there before and they stood. And they were able to block you. They were able to stop you. They were able to sabotage you. They were able to confuse you. But tonight God is saying, as long as you do not allow the word of God to come out of your mouth, it will be here day and night. You will speak the word on a daily basis. Every challenge will be responded by the word of God. Every prayer will be included in the word of God. Every believer will be have the word of God in it. As long as this word does not depart from you day and night, no man will stand before you. Why? Because when they stand before you, you do not have to deal with them. The word that you speak is sharp enough to cut through and make a way for you. Then he continues and tells him, haven't I told you to be strong and courageous? And I will be with you all the days of your life. Tonight, being young people, I know you would love to have your husband and your wife for the rest of your life. Hakuna feeling poa kama unakatiwa. Alafu mtu akwambie, I will be with you for the rest of your life. I will love you forever. Hakuna feeling poa kama mtu akupatie assurance. I will be paying you 50,000 per week for the rest of your life. Hiyo kwanza na ukikui yangu yote hiyo ai. Ningeambiwa ati pastor, God, Mungu aniambie, I will make sure you will be getting 100,000 every week when you speak my word. But angalia, bila your assurance, I'm still speaking it. Because I know, someone may promise me the money and never give me. Someone may promise me the hand and never give me. Someone may promise me heaven and never give me. But when the word of God speaks, God himself will have to fulfill it because he will never go against his word. So, description ya Mungu kwa ufupi. Mungu hana nyaunya amekaa hivi. Anagoja ukosee, akunyoroshe. Mungu ana dimensions. Mungu ana dimensions. Ya, dimension ya kwanza nataka kuonesha yani nani? Mungu sio kama binadamu, Mungu ujisikia. Oh, where description yake ya Mungu iko distorted. Mungu ujisikia. Alifika mahali akauliza Moses, who am I that I should contend with man? One of the next time hivyo alikuwa analia, who am I that I, alikuwa anajujua. Moses, let me ask you, who am I that I should contend with man? Kwani binadamu ni nani mimi na yeye tushindane? Tunaulizana nini? Nini tunauzana? Hakuna. Mnataka aelewe niko juu bana, niko juu. Binadamu anaelewa niko juu, niko juu. Wewe ndio Mungu. Pande nyingine yake, I'm loving, I'm caring, I'm forgiving. Huyo bado ni Jehova. Inadepend huko pande gani? Na unamuona kutoka wapi? Because kama unashindana na yeye, lazima utaona ile sura yake ya. I say, vipi, mimi na wewe hatuwezi shindana. Lazima untambue mimi ni nani. And this is the reason kwa nini Mungu alitaka wana wa Israeli waachiliwe. In the whole of the world, only Israelites knew how to praise God. And when they were in captivity, they could not praise God. All they could do is pray for their deliverance. So, God akiwa heaven, hii ndio ukweli alikuwa ameboeka.
400 years, hakuna sifa inakam. Mbaga kakaka, hey Moses, nimesikia kilio cha watu wangu, itabidi uende uwa deliver so that they can praise me. Hiyo tu. Hiyo ndio ilikuwa reason, so that they can praise me. Kilio yao nimeshikia, lakini condition ya hao kwa free, lazima wanisifu. So unaweza imagine, sasa leo umekataa kusifu Mungu vile uboeka na wewe. Amekufanyia kila kitu lakini bado uko, Mungu, kwa nini? Kwa nini ilienda hivi? Neke. Si hata ushukuru kwanza. Ukiwa mtoto mdogo, uliambiwa, uliingia kwa sufuria, inachemka maji. Na wewe ndio huyu saa hii. Na hujapaka powder, ndio uficha kitu yoyote, uko tu sawa. So shukuru Mungu. Ya kwamba magari zimeanguka, gari megongana, gari ulifa upande, iligongana nyuma yako, gari ulikuwa umepanda, isha roll ingine hata. Lakini wewe bado mpaka wa leo, hauna chuma kwa mguu, uko tu sawa. Na hata kama uko nayo, bado unatembea na uko hai, uko afadhali kuliko maiti imelala. Alafu bado unakaa unauza Mungu, why? Let me answer you why. Because you are a... Sijasema kitu. You have a reason to give him praise. Now, let me finish. The dispensation of the Joshua generation praised God. That is why God tells Joshua, the promise I gave to their fathers, how can now their fathers, your land, I will give it to them. So you, Joshua, will be able to divide the inheritance to them when they get there. So I want you to cross over. The Joshua generation knew how to praise God. And that is why they were able to inherit the land. Na ndio maana unaona Moses. Moses alikuwa na contend na watu. Na kuna point ilifika akasikizana na watu. Alikuja akaambia God, mimi nataka ufanye hivi. God alikuja akamwambia Moses, I want to destroy these people. Moses akakaa akaangalia. Uko serious? Unitoe kwa wife. Unilete hapa kwa farao tushindane sijui siku ngapi hapa. Baadaye unipitishie aibu, karibu niaibishe Red Sea, ukaifungua. Baada ya hiyo tumevuka, wasome teta wakateta wakateta, ikabidi umeleta mkate na nyama. Hiyo tu nikiona. Baadaye wakateta usiku, ukawaletea heater. Mchana ukawaletea AC. Alafu sayo unasema unataka kumaliza. Hebu kwa serious, mimi sifanyai kazi ya utoto. Kama unataka kumaliza watu, futa jina langu kwa kitabu chako. Mungu akakaa akaangalia jina ya Moses kitabu. By then kitabu ya Mungu haikuwa na wase wengi. So alikaa kaona amongest watu wa maana, upsi, yuko kama number 5 hivi. Eh, nikimtoa hii kitabu yangu ikaita kwa wase, akaona tu waya tu nichore. Lakini sasa ndio Mungu ni nani? Mungu alisema atamaliza watu. Ukweli aliwamaliza baadaye tu. Lakini hakuambia Moses. Alijua nikimwambia huyu tutagombana, aliwamaliza bado. Learn never to argue with God. Learn never to argue with God. And learn to listen to the voice of God. And learn to follow the ways of God. It is a new dispensation. And this dispensation, what will make you make it is when you do not allow the word of God to depart from your lips. When ingombe, amen. Siwe na iwe hivyo, ikurudie. Why? Because you will always have a reason to speak negative. Simule ambu hapa juzi vile wa Nigeria waongea. Natasha alituambia kwamba alienda Nigeria. Akafika kwa lift. Walikuwa na haraka. Lift ikafunguka akapata mnaijo ndani. Akauza mnaijo, are you going down? Mnaigeria akamwangalia. Who, me? Going down? I'm not going down.
I refuse to go down in Jesus' name. If you are asking if the lift is going down, the lift is going, but I am not going down.
Well, okay, this one. Nibaya lunch. Ayaya, sina kakitu. Alafu na kam church. Father, mbono umeniacha maombi tu ya kunungunika mdomo. Badilisha. Change how you speak. If you're sensitive with the way you speak, and that is why unaonaga iko watu, iko cultures kama Nigerians, ukiona Nigeria maskini na Mkenya maskini. Mnigeria maskini ni tajiri ya maskini wa Kenya. Because of the way they confess. And they are very radical. So I want you to be that radical. Ya kwamba anything unaambiwa negative, unasema that is not my portion. Hata your boss akikwambia you are useless, unamwambia excuse me sir, I refuse that in Jesus' name. Hata kama ni mzazi wako akikwambia wewe uwezi, unamwambia thanks, naweza sana. Hata kama haujaweza, unasema naweza. Because sisi wenyewe ndio tulijiroga. Ushaona saa hizi hata toy tudogo. Juzi nimeenda sijui tuko wapi, niko na katoi kadogo, alafu mtu amepita akasema wa, ako kanakaa kama nani? Sasa nikashindwa, amesema nani? Mama yake akasema eh, atakuwa kama yeye. Nikajua eh, huyo nani lazima kumpoa. Alafu tulikuwa tukiwatoi, angalia advertisements zilikuwa gani. When I grow up, I want to be a pilot. When I grow up, weka wangalie. Na ujue, hii dunia, haikuwa gifea. Tuliko tunena mahali hii weekend. Na nilikuwa na DJ Kelv. Na Ambro. The two mad men I have around me. Completely mad. And tuliko tunenda na dhani side za Runda. Wakaona billboard, wakasema wa, unaona, huku, wanaeka billboard ya Turkish Airways. Ukienda Eastlands. Kwa sababu gani, washaka wakageji. Watu wa huku ukieka Turkish Airways, watu wanaini matusi unawatukana. Hata kama kuna wasoko Eastlands na uenda majuu. Just yet hakuna wako. Lakini dunia inakushape vile nataka wewe ukue. Si yet hakuna watu wametoka Eastlands wako majuu leo. Wako tena wengi. Wengi sana. Lakini sasa dunia inataka think in this way because this is where you are. Sasa wewe unakataa kuthink kama wao. You think as the word that is in you says. Ukitaka kuja na kuambia ukweli, kaa angalie. Na nataka ukwe very serious. Hata wakati wa kampeni kifika, piga raundi Karen, piga raundi Runda, piga raundi hizi estate za Kidosi Kidosi. Ukipata billboard za kampeni ni moja moja, sio kila mahali, because hao hawashughuliki na hizo. Enda huku kwa ghetto. Ni kwa sababu gani? Ni kwa sababu wanajua huko ndio kura iko, lakini huku kwingine ndio pesa iko. Sasa wewe, sitaki ufikirie vile wanakuambia, nataka ufikirie kulingana vile word imekuambia. You are not under, but you are above. You are not the tail, but you are the head. Somebody say amen. Na kuna scripture inasema kwa Job, nilisoma juzi hapa, hata ili nistua, that I am your God and I will be your gold. I am your God and I will be your gold. In other words, nikikukamata, niko sawa. Kipesa, kikila kitu. So why should we think like the world wants us to think? Na ndio maana Bible inajicorrect na inajisema vizuri. Na inajicombine pamoja ndio ikubaliane. Do not be conformed to the standards of this world. But be ye transformed by the word of God. Tonight, we are going to claim our position where we belong in the new dispensation in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord.
I believe you have been blessed so far by Word Insight from Rod and Fire Maximum Miracle Center. I want to give you an opportunity to experience what you have been experiencing for the past years. What is that? The man, Jesus Christ, being your Lord and your personal Savior. You want to give your life to Jesus? Kindly repeat this prayer after me in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, I give you my life. Forgive me for every sin I have committed against you. Tonight, I repent with all my heart and I declare with my mouth, Jesus died and rose again. I am born again. I am born again in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you because of this believer who has just surrendered their life to you. I pray in the name of Jesus, you are not going to backslide. I declare you are not going to backslide. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. I saturate you with the power of God that from tonight you are going to experience God in a bigger and a mightier way. In the name of Jesus, no demon, no devil will interrupt your life, but you are going to flow with Jesus all the days of your life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My viewer, you just received Jesus as your personal Savior. My prayer and my urge to you, there is a number on the bottom of this screen right now. 0711-359-478. Kindly call that number. Text that number, WhatsApp that number, we will get back to you. We have beautiful gifts we want to give you for receiving Jesus to help you grow. And what are those gifts? We have wonderful Bibles to give unto you. There are youth in this church who sat and said, we are going to sponsor as many as we can with Bibles. They buy Bibles and we give out Bibles to people who are born again. Kindly call that number right now. We are waiting. Call that number. WhatsApp that number or text that number and we will give this beautiful gift of a Bible unto you. Because the only gift we can give to you right now when you're born again is the Word of God. Kindly call that number. Communicate to us on Facebook. We are on Facebook, Rod and Fire. We are also on Facebook through my page. It is written Pastor Young or Andrew Muiru or Andrew Muiru Jr., whichever page you decide to use as they appear on your screen, kindly use those pages and we'll get back to you and we'll be able to intermingle with you and interact with you because we have many activities going on in our church. God bless you and see you when you call us in Jesus' name. God bless you. We love you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.